The way Aula lives a life has had a profound effect on me lately. Oh, hang on a second, we're out of tune there. Left a little bit. There we go. Perfect. Just tuning us in. Brilliant there. Welcome, my friends, to the show. Very well. It's day 46. The time is 5:29. This is Big Brother's Little Brother. Or Ang Meletak Itpataka Atabing in Powid K Ag Bigger Larawan, as they say in the Philippines. As it's Tuesday, we're going to be going live to the Big Brother house in just a couple of minutes as Big Brother reveals who's up for eviction this week. Maybe. But that's not all. Actress Angela Griffin's here to air her views. Oh, lovely Angela. And etiquette expert Liz Brewer's going to be on hand to whip Maxwell Manners into shape, ready for a hot date with Saskia. But it is Tuesday, which means we're going live to the house to reveal Big Brother's second lie. Take a look.
This is Big Brother.
Hello.
The housemates nominated for eviction this week are, in alphabetical order, Anthony and Craig
and
Kemal.
You three nominated then.
That's an interesting one, isn't it?
Oh,
mm-hmm.
Yeah.
Fabulous.
Kamal, you lied.
You didn't, Kamal.
I did.
You lied.
I didn't lie. No one asked me whether I
asked you, and you said you didn't.
No, you didn't.
Of course I did.
Did you nominate? Did you?
I said that's what they would do. I knew they would.
Oh. No, one or the other.
I went in there and I decided I should nominate.
You're turning into Maxwell.
Kamal.
I think it's hilarious. That same morning, I goes like this to you.
I go. Yeah.
That's interesting.
I go.
So
you nominate. Yeah, he says you went into
I didn't nominate.
I didn't
ask to still do. You know what I mean?
I'm not making
school boy error.
I knew they would do that though. Oh, I said to you, didn't I? Did I not said that to you?
Don't worry
about it. But I don't care though.
Yeah,
come on, you're right.
I'm fine.
I didn't do that.
Fine, yeah.
I swear down. I thought we'd be up.
I thought. Well, well.
I'm not up. Take nominated to be up.
Right. It all gets a little bit confusing now, and bear with me, because I found out about this about 5 minutes ago. As far as we know, Anthony Craig and Kamal are up. But that is Big Brother's second lie. Anthony Craig and Kamal aren't up. The fact is that Derek, Eugene, Mikosi, Orla, Science and Vanessa didn't nominate, which is against the rules, and therefore are up for eviction. However, there's now another twist, which is this. The two housemates with the most public votes will both face eviction on Friday, where their fellow housemates will decide which of the two will get the boot live on Davina's show. Oh, I've been having palpitations about that for the last 10 minutes. Who faces the housemates' vote? You decide. Which is all very civilized. These numbers are cool. To vote, call 09016 1616, followed by 03 for Derek, 06 for Mikosi, 12 for Science, 13 for Vanessa, 14 for Eugene, or 15 for Orla. Or text the name of the person you want to vote for to 644. Oh, And here is one happy camper. It's Maxwell, everybody. Now, Maxwell, the funniest thing there is when the initial nominations were announced, you had your head in your hands.
I cannot believe this. No, I did actually think if it all went smoothly this year, the nominations were exactly the same as they have been, I thought probably Andy and Craig would be up. Mm-hmm. So that has just made my day. I want to raise a glass of them later on and just like, because they don't know, do they?
How do you think they took the news? Because now it's going to be fantastic to watch for the next couple of days because they think they're up.
Of course, yeah. Well, they're going to be out of bin for the last few days by themselves. Do you know what I mean? So having a chat late into the evening, whatever else is sleeping at half 10 at night.
How do you think Kamal will take it?
I think he'll probably think that the girls have obviously voted for him, because I'm not sure how it's been going, but I think they've gone in there and nominated, so he's going to think that they don't like him, this, that, and the other.
But... sure. Okay, brilliant. Thank you very much, Max, everybody. I didn't get my head around it. Okay, Big Brother's lying task has caused no end of paranoia in the house, and with me, I don't trust them anymore. With that in mind, today's Cool BBLB is quite simply, if you were Big Brother, what lie would you tell to the housemates, or indeed me? These numbers to call. You can call BBLB on 09011 101 101. 09011 101 101. Or you can text us. All you have to do is text studio and your comment to 83188, 83188, or of course email us, bblb@channel4.com. That's bblb@channel4.com. Hello there, I'm kissing a mother, a young mother, slightly inappropriately. Joining me now for a natter is Big Brother fan, actress and yummy mummy, Andrew Griffin, everybody.
Thank you very much.
How are you?
Uber fan.
Are you an Uber
fan? Not even tiny fan, Uber fan.
So what do you make of the lies? Because I don't like it.
Do you know what, I didn't start to like it, but then do you know what, now I'm thinking it's fantastic.
I mean, I guess they have to keep upping the bar and they have to mess with their minds and so forth, and that's definitely going to happen this week, but it just unnerves me. I don't know where they're going to go next.
Do you know what, but that's what's making this Big Brother, to me, the best one, because they are always, always up in the stakes and you really don't know, and that's the beauty of it.
So how do you think the housemates will react to the truth? Because presumably... I mean, I don't know how it's going to work on Friday, but I presume Davina's going to do a show and then let them know at the very start so they'll have an hour to stew in their own juices.
Yeah. Do you know what? I think, hopefully, they will be very sportsman about it and go, there you go, there's Big Brother.
I doubt it.
Why not?
Because they're housemates. It's not what they do. Okay. They go ballistic.
I think that some of them, obviously, will be very, very pleased. I think it's such a great thing to throw in.
Really?
Yeah, of course it is.
I'm still undecided. I've got to be honest with you. Found out about it 10 minutes ago. That's probably it. And who do you think should go and who do you think should stay?
Do you know what? I think it might have to be Vanessa.
Vanessa to go.
Because I have no real opinion of her, but everyone else seems to really, really dislike her. So it's like, oh, okay, and she doesn't really do very much. I'd be really sorry to lose any of the others
A lot of people have said this, kind of in the last couple of minutes since I found out, I think, oh, Vanessa probably will be up. But if she's into the last two and she's up against... well, let's say, for the sake of argument, Orla, and the housemates have to decide, Orla or Eugene, the housemates have to decide who goes, then I think, you know, the fair thing to do in terms of, if I was in the house, the fair thing to do would be to say, well, I guess Orla has to go because she's been in there less time than Vanessa.
And Orla just has to go.
Oh, really?
Oh, she bores me stupid.
Why?
She's so beautiful, and she is so beautiful, with a beautiful body, but that's all she is. Oh my God. That's all she says the whole time. All she does is talk about everybody else, and she has nothing. She doesn't seem to have much of a personality
herself.
She's very
pretty, but she is
beautiful.
She's a bit too tall for me.
Ah, right, okay.
It's like eating a Thompson's gazelle rather than a nice Aberdeen Angus.
Right, okay.
That's the way I look at it.
Nice.
Now then, having played a hairdresser in Corrie and worked in the salon in cutting it, you must have a fair good idea about appearances when it comes to hair, okay?
Yeah.
Let's remind ourselves of our very own Brady Bunch first.
I love my big hair. And big hair is so in at the moment.
I feel like I'd be like Cleopatra. And the sign said, long-haired freaky people need not apply. And the sign said, long-haired freaky people need not apply. And the sign said, long-haired freaky people need not apply. And the sign said, long-haired freaky people need not apply.
If you're going to get a skinhead, you may as well do it in here.
Okay, so who do you think's got the best hair in the house?
I think it used to be Macozy. I used to think she had the best hair, then it's found out it's a weave. So I'm going to say science.
Now, I don't know where girls stand on weaves. How does that whole thing work? Do you look down on someone with a weave?
Well, no. If it's a very good weave, which hers was, it isn't now. It's looking a little bit tatty now.
Do you think it was a bit of a silly move to go into the house on a weave?
I don't know what she's going to do.
Surely maintenance must be so difficult.
Well, the thing is, you can keep them for about 2 months, but after that, they do start to look tatty, and I don't know what she's going to do. Maybe Craig will do her hair.
And also, do you think she's got the worst hair now?
Yeah, she has. I love Science's hair. I keep touching my leg.
It's quite nice. It's very Wogan-esque.
I like Science's hair. And Mikosi has to go to the bottom of the class, actually, for the fact that it's a weave. Science, au naturel.
We wondered if you'd maybe give some of the housemates a hair makeover. Join me now, please, as we play Hair Do and Hair Don't.
Nice. Nice. Did you make that up?
I didn't make it up, but I paid someone else to make it up. first, we have Derek. Now, obviously, I like the fact Derek has no hair.
Yeah.
At least he shaves his hair, OK?
Absolutely. It suits him, absolutely.
So, how would you change it if you had the opportunity to? If you said, Derek, I'm going to have a party, I want Derek to come around, but he needs to wear something on his head. Out of all these wonderful options we've given you, where would
you... Do you know what? Sorry, Derek, but I think it has to be this one, doesn't it? Can you put that on?
He's like Connell look.
Do you know what I mean?
Wonderful. Could Derek be... We were talking last week about Derek being the next leader of the Tory party. Could Derek be the next leader of the Tory party with that?
With that hair, yes. Before that hair, no.
No, okay, fair enough. Now,
needs the hair.
Next up, we've got Kamal.
Oh, lovely Kamal.
That's Kamal's natural look at the moment. But
which is a very, very good look, I'm thinking.
Do you like
well,
his
hair?
Well,
yeah, do you know, you can swap. It can be a boy, it can be a girl, you know, feminine, not feminine,
it's
up, down.
It's adaptable, isn't it?
Very adaptable.
But get rid of that for a second.
I'm actually quite...
And what would you fancy?
All right, let's make him one or the other. What should we have him as? Girl.
Yeah.
And I know he'd love the ribbon.
Beautiful.
He looks a bit Diana Ross.
It works, I like it. okay, and lastly, Orla. Get rid of that straight away.
Well, can we not just keep her? Like... Yeah, I'd keep her like that. Let's see if she has any personality beyond that beauty. Yeah,
you like that?
Yeah, I do really like it.
She's like something from V. Remember that thing with Alien?
There we go, see?
Beautiful. Or Alien Nation.
All right, go on, I'm going to stick one
go on
her.
One.
Let's make her really, really rancid. Oh, no, that kind of suits her.
I like that.
This
looks
like my hair.
I know, I was thinking that. I wasn't going to say it.
I think that might be the cutout.
Oh,
there we go.
Oh, it's Orla and Angela all together. Look, wonderful. Thank you very much, Angela, everybody. Woo! Orla and Angela later on. OK, right now, evil big brother, because they are evil, they're messing with my head, needs your help. Earlier today, the housemates were set a big brother games task. We're not allowed to say Olympian, so it's a games task, where they'll compete a series of sporting events. As Kamal's got a dicky tummy, he has to be the commentator and will sing the national anthem of the opening ceremony tomorrow. All he has to do is decide which national anthem he should sing. Should it be the Welsh national anthem, which is Land of My Fathers, and sounds like this? The thing is, you can't do jokes from national anthems because so many people write in and complain. It's really cool to be Welsh. Or English, which is Land of Hope and Glory. Hope and glory. It's also cool to be English.
Nice.
Got to tick all boxes there, haven't I,
nice.
Angela? Or lastly, Scottish, which is Flower of Scotland by Ron Rigg. Oh, Flower of Scotland.
It's good to be Scotland.
We're really cool. Scotland, really cool. If you think it should be Welsh, then text poll, then a space, then A to 83188. If you think it should be English, then text poll, then a space, then B to 83188. Or if you think it should be Scottish, text poll, then a space, then C to 83188. We will announce the result at the end of the show. Join us after the break when Maxwell is going to be transformed into a gentleman before your very eyes. It'll be like Pygmalion. But before that, let's have our daily dose of Learn to Speak Max. Well, we'll see you in three.
Today's phrase is giving it all a lemon. The full phrase is giving it all a lemon peel, which, in Cockney rhyming slang, is lemon peel, spiel. It means giving it all the talk. So, if a bloke next to you in a pub is mouthing off, you would say, here, hark at him giving it all a lemon. You know it makes sense. Right, I'm off. Someone look after me stall.
I'll explain all in a second. Welcome back to Big Brother's Little Brother. It's day 47. The time is 5:46. Over the last 47 days, the housemates have broken wind. They've belched, they've spoken with the mouthful and wiped the noses on the T-shirts, and that's just science. I find it frankly disgusting. Here to give us a rundown of the House of Horrors is etiquette expert Liz Brewer, everybody. Liz.
Hiya.
Mwah. It's so nice to meet you. How many kisses do we do?
And the other one.
I could be there all day. That was wonderful. OK, so from what we've seen, how do you think this year's bunch have behaved so far?
Well, I have to admit that some of those bodily functions I thought were grotesque.
Yes.
They're obsessed with them, aren't they?
It is. I mean, do you think it's because they're in the house together and so forth? It's that kind of positive environment?
I don't know. I don't know whether it's when you are isolated like that and maybe after a certain time you let your ambitions down and everything, and I think nose-picking and burping and...
Oh dear.
I mean, the whole thing became pretty repulsive.
Who's the worst offender from who you've seen?
I don't think there's much to choose between them, but I thought the nose-picking, that science was pretty grotesque. I thought that was disgraceful.
It's horrible, isn't it? Okay. Can I just say how my diction's improved immediately by just sitting next to you? Not only are you beautiful, but I'm speaking better. Can I just hang out with you all the time? It's fantastic. OK, here's a small selection of the housemate's horrible habits.
OK.
Let's take a look.
That is disgusting, Maxwell.
Door open so I can speak to the boys.
Oh, my God!
I've just dropped my guts.
Oh, yeah, a nice big poo in a minute.
You made me laugh.
Oh, yeah!
Whoa!
Oh, thank you so much for that, Nate.
Craig, come over and have a look at my wall of bogeys.
Oh, well, yeah, thanks. Oh.
They're a terrible shower. What do we make of that?
Water bogeys.
I know, it's too
going to do a big poo.
I'm sorry.
What is this?
I'm sorry, it's people living in a house and they behave deplorably. I'm
disgusting.
Sorry. I'm apologising for bringing you down. OK, now, you know Derek.
I do, yes.
Why is
I
it?
Know
anyone
Derek.
That's well-bred that comes on the show, they all know Derek. It's
I'm amazed because I think he's wonderful, but I thought that the viewing public wouldn't appreciate his sort of nuances, but he's still very much in there.
Absolutely, OK.
I think they're fascinated. But he is exactly as you see him.
Really?
Yeah, exactly.
I can't imagine him to be any different, so yeah. I certainly believe that. OK, now, listen, we've got a small challenge for you.
Right.
Maxwell has yet not officially taken Saskia out on a proper date.
Ah.
OK? Now, we want you to give him some tips.
Seems to have done everything else.
He has, but he hasn't sealed the deal in the right way.
Cemented.
Yes, we want you to give him some tips on how to be the perfect gentleman. If you come down, we have a restaurant setting here, and I believe I'm playing the waiter. Here we go. Wonderful, OK. Maxwell is going to be dating the lovely Angela. It's Dermy's restaurant. Oh, hello there, Maxwell. How are you?
Oh, mate. Angela, sit yourself down there, darling.
Hold on.
Look, this is how it's going to work. Liz is going to give you some pointers as to how to do this properly. Liz, over to you.
Cheers, Maxwell.
Yes, darling.
Whatever you might think, and this is a precious flower, you have to show your masculinity.
Precious flower.
You have to look after her. Nurture her.
Right.
Get her to the chair. Okay. Make certain that you pull out the chair so she can sit down.
And not too far so she sits up on the floor, right?
No, we don't need that.
Treat her with respect.
With respect. You want her to blossom.
Come on.
Go for it.
You're trying to make an impression.
How about this, Liz? Yeah. What do you reckon?
Come on, Maxwell.
Angela, I'm treating you like a flower. You'd like to sit your petals down there, sweetheart?
Your petals down, kid.
Petals down.
Wonderful.
Wicked.
Okay. Now sit yourself down, Maxwell. Well done.
You going to put out a chair for me, darling?
No, I'm not.
Sorry,
Yeah, can I just say, I'm glad you made such an effort with dressing on this amazing
I'm glad you did, Liz.
I did, Liz. I did.
Look at this. Yes.
Okay,
she was fantastic.
So, now, with the serviettes, how do we work that one?
Table napkins.
Yeah, sorry, table napkins.
Let me just explain why. Okay, only because a serviette's paper and these are definitely linen.
Mm.
So, as a little lesson.
Thank you.
Okay. So now put them on your lap. That's so that just in case the waiter is not very good, he might drop something down your amazing
Liz, look what he's doing. Should he be doing that?
Mark, you having seen him eat whatever it was, spaghetti, I'm not surprised because it was so disgusting.
OK.
So and he did dribble everything.
Shall I serve the food?
Yes, why don't we?
Lovely.
Surprise.
Steak and chips, please, Dermot.
Now, hold on a minute, we haven't got anything to drink.
Oh, I'm so sorry. That's
do you not think?
Oh, that smells really nice.
Yes, Maxwell, you need to sort of say, would you like a drink?
Well, we're going to go straight up for mineral water because I'm a bit short of cash, so.
No, that's not making a good impression.
Is it
not?
Right, okay, sorry.
So there you are, lucky girl, you've got some champagne.
Nice. Okay.
Bottoms up.
Right,
okay,
lovely.
Oh, hold on a minute.
No, 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 no. Fappanapoli.
What are you talking about? That's all right.
Getting it wrong, kid.
I don't I don't think Angela's in the least bit interested in your bottom being up, down, or anywhere else. So let's forget the bottoms up,
so
shall we?
Lovely. Okay, last one. Shall I serve
okay,
up now?
Why not?
Thank you.
Yeah.
Bon appetit.
Oh, it looks lovely.
That's it, mate. All right. It's fine. You have to eat now and see what she thinks of your eating.
Oh, don't worry about it.
Now, hold on a minute.
Oh, no, 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 no. She can't even eat, look. She's lost her appetite.
Don't want to stay on me, Dave. If you really did that, she would leave.
I would.
I mean, that is the most disgusting thing you could do. When you're eating, we don't want to see the inside of your mouth.
Liz, I think it's beyond help.
It's so disgusting.
I'm sorry. One last question now. It's the end of the meal.
And let me just show him how to do this.
Oh, yes, no, absolutely.
Spaghetti is difficult because we noticed that on screen. The reason you got a spoon is really to help.
Okay.
But what you do is you take a little bit here and then you twiddle it round here. They've made it even easier. They've cut the spaghetti. Normally you twiddle it round.
You can have a bite if you like.
I won't.
Are we talking about spaghetti still?
We are talking about spaghetti. Right, and then it goes neatly into your mouth.
Wonderful. Okay, and lastly, when it comes to the bill, what would you do?
Oh, you never guess what? I've left it in the motor.
No, she would guess, and she doesn't happen to have any money with her, so you're going to jolly well
be washing the dishes, wouldn't I?
Brilliant.
No, no, no. This is a proper date.
I've left, I'm gone.
Maxwell, has that helped at all with your first date for Saskia?
Hopefully, we'll find out in due course.
Yeah, well, let's hopefully find out in due course.
Goes,
thank you very much, Liz,
everybody. If it goes like this, you're a runner.
Thank you.
Mwah. Mwah.
Mwah. Mwah. Mwah. Oh, that was wonderful. Now then. We've shut up shop. The restaurant's closed, so we can have a bit of a natter. It's Cool BBLB. Let's go to Cool BBLB right now. Hello there. Who's that? Who's first up? It's Tracy from London.
Hi, Dermot.
Hello. How are you?
I'm fine.
Go for it, hun. What lie would you tell the housemates?
I would tell the housemates, I would give them all a secret mission and tell them if the other housemates find out that each of them have got a secret mission, they'll be automatically up for eviction.
You are a fiendish genius.
I am.
And in terms of the strings to be pulling inside of the house, who would you like to annoy the most?
I'd like Derek to run around. His thing would be he has to run around the garden and pretend to be a chicken, and nobody would know why he's doing it.
Excellent. Thank you very much.
If he completes his task, he gets his personal trainer or something that he really wants.
I like that.
I love bark like a dog, isn't
and
it?
I love your voice as well. Pretty much that's all we've got time for. I believe Scotland has won. Kamala is singing the Scottish National Anthem at 52%. We'll see you tomorrow. Nominations uncut tonight, 7:30. We're back tomorrow at 5:25. Take care, everyone.